Romeo and Juliet begins with a monologue, a summary of a play. It may seem peculiar that Shakespeare gives away the plot of the entire play at the very beginning. The monologue gives the audience a sense of dread throughout the play. Even while watching the most joyful scenes, the audience still has a perception of foreboding, as this play is both a tragedy and comedy. And this is exactly what Shakespeare would have wanted.
Two households both alike in dignity. In fair Verona, where we lay our scene, from ancient grudge break to a new immunity, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean, from forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a pair of star-crossed lovers take their life, whose misadventures piteous overthrows, doff with their death bearer their parent's strength. The fearful passage of their death-marked love and the continuance of their parents' rage, which but their children's dead not could remove, is now the 2 hours' traffic of our stage. The which, if you with patient ears attend, what here shall miss, our toil shall strive to mend.
Moment is joyful to see Juliet, stating that his love for Rosaline was not truly love, for it is nothing compared to his love for Juliet.
What lame that which doth enrich the hand of young and light, did my heart love to now forswear its sight, for I never saw true beauty.
Only son, my hated, my only love.
The scene showed us how both of the lovers expressed their love for each other and how they talked about how they wanted to get married. Juliet agreed to speak with Romeo because she is also in love with him.
But soft what light through yonder window breaks. It is my lady, oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew she were. She speaks, yet she says nothing. What of that?
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father, and refuse thy name. Or if thou wilt not, be but sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a captive.
What's in the name? That which we call a rose. By add another word, would smell as sweet. So Romeo would, were he not Romeo called, retain the dear perfection which he owns. Without that title, Romeo doth the name. And for the name, which is not part of the name, take all myself.
Romeo and Juliet's wedding was a secret. No one knew they were getting married. It was Friar Lawrence's idea. He was hoping that if they got married, their parents would stop fighting.
Come with me, and you will make short work. For by your leave, you shall not stay alone.
This act was unfair because Romeo wanted to avenge his friend. Now Romeo is upset because he will not be able to see Juliet.
The judgment vanished from his lips. Not body's death, but body's banishment.
Where thou as young as I, Juliet, thy love, in hour but married, tibula murdered, me banished, then mightiest thou speak, then mightiest thou tear my hair and fall upon the ground as I do now, taking the measure of an unmade grave.
In the last scene, when Romeo thinks that Juliet is dead, but she's in a deep sleep, so when Romeo kills himself, Juliet wakes up and she kills herself. This play was a whole show in that you could be different in playwriting. Shakespeare wanted to change what's going on in playwriting at that time to include both comedy and tragedy in the same play. He's trying to say that we don't need to fight, but if we do better, if we were treating each other better. Even if parents fight, it will still find a way to affect the kids somehow, some way.
Here lies Juliet, her beauty makes us faint, feasting on this food. Death that hath sucked the honey of her breath, hath no power upon thy beauty. Here's to my love, O true apothecary. False with a kiss, I will die.
dagger, this thy sheath, and there rest and let me die.
A gloomy peace this morning with it brings. The sun for sorrow will not show his head. Go hence to have more talk of these sad things. Some shall be pardoned, and some shall be punished. For never was a story of more woes than this of her Juliet and her Romeo.